Funerals from the synagogue shootings are scheduled for today. Brothers Cecil and David Rosenthal, Dr. Jerry Rabinowitz being laid to rest as more harrowing stories emerge from the worst anti-Semitic attack in U.S. history.
80-year-old Judah Samet survived 10 months in a concentration camp as a child. He says he always arrives on time for the 9:45 service at the Tree of Life, but was running a few minutes late when he got there Saturday.
And all of a sudden I see this guy standing right outside my car behind the wall with a pistol, and he started shooting. And he was shooting two, three. The other guy was answering with rapid fire.
Do you hate the man who did this?
No, I don't know. I hate what he did, but I don't know the guy. But evidently, he's a subhuman.
The suspect made his first court appearance Monday on charges of federal murder and assault. He was detained without bond. Two of the four Pittsburgh police officers who he is said to have wounded remain hospitalized. Parts of the downtown Pittsburgh skyline lit blue overnight to honor the victims from the Tree of Life Synagogue.
All right, let's bring in historian and Princeton University professor Julian Zelizer, a CNN political analyst, and from her hometown of Pittsburgh, Washington Examiner reporter, New York Post columnist Selena Zito, a CNN contributor. Good morning to both of you.
Hi, guys.
Good morning. Selena, nobody knows this town better than you. I've been there many times. It is arguably the toughest, grittiest town in this country, a fantastic place. How is your city doing? Is it too soon for the president to visit?
You know, the city obviously is incredibly sad. I was on the scene on Saturday. I've been covering it ever since. This is a neighborhood that I've known all of my life and attended weddings there and bar mitzvahs and, you know, just a great community. But, you know, there's this resiliency about Pittsburghers that's hard to describe, although I think it's very common in cities across and small towns across the country where, you know, people come together and they unite over a variety of different races and ethnicities and religions. And when something hits your community, you grieve together, but you also are strong together. There's this great creed, it's called the Pittsburgher Creed, that was written in 1914 about past Pittsburghers and what there was an expectation of what Pittsburgh would look like in the future. And it's incredibly accurate about the strength and resiliency of people in this city. Is it too soon for the president to come? Look, I think it's normal that presidents get criticized when they come to these moments. They're criticized if they don't come. I think the president's going to put his head down. He and his wife and his daughter and son-in-law are going to visit with whoever wants him to visit, and then they're going to leave, and that's what they should do. Mm-hmm. Politics aside, this is not time for politics.
Oh, yeah, well, there's a lot of moments that aren't time for politics, and politics, unfortunately,
right,
creep in.
Yeah.
You know, Julian, you know, she talks about the moment this is, mm-hmm, and these sorts of moments show a lot about a president and about a leader. How is the president doing, in your view, as the consoler-in-chief here?
I think so far there hasn't been much consoler-in-chief. And within the Jewish community, he's a very controversial president. There's a reason his ratings are under a quarter of the Jewish community, and there are many who believe that he has stoked some of the fires of this country that led to this horrific event. Not that he caused it, not that he's responsible, but he's created a bad climate. So there are many Jews in Pittsburgh, there are many Jews nationally who this doesn't sit well. And in terms of politics, he went right back on the political campaign trail, and not only that, he gave a speech that night, which was his standard rhetoric. So at this point, he hasn't pulled back from the politics. He hasn't pulled back from the controversy. And so this is not your normal circumstances with a president visiting. But the Jewish community is very sorrowful right now.